Let's see in another example how it is done again. You see again a four-chamber view. Now the four-chamber view is focused on the left ventricle. You can delineate the endocardial borders quite nicely, but still we can adjust it a little bit. We again do the automatic imaging and it places us this region of interest on our field of view. Now we can adjust the ROI width already so that it is optimal, and we can adjust what we see, and also we can simply turn up the gain a little bit to even delineate the endocardial borders better. So this is better for MRI and better to see. So there are certain pitfalls. Not only the ROI per se is important, but also how you can see, for example, hypertrophy. So if there is an hypertrophied region, you can use this part on the outside to even trace the myocardium better, but always be aware that you want to keep it in a range where it is okay. So you can make this ROI tremendously huge. So now let's do that and just exemplify how that would look like, how the tracing would look like. And of course, the tracing on the outer parts is different compared to the inner parts. So we are not in the myocardium anymore, but we are also tracing the surrounding tissues, which explains a lower value. In this case, we do not want to do that. Even though the curves are quite nicely, we do know from the B-mode image that this cannot be a good view. So we just stop it. We do not want to use these measurements. So we try this again and we take the automatic software and we try to delineate the borders nicely. Now we do it the other way around. We make the region of interest very, very small. So now the myocardium is not entirely traced. And you see that now the machine has problems to follow the myocardium. This is quite a nice teaching point, because in this case, you can see that the myocardium, how it moves, is not traced, and how the speckles are moving around, this cannot be optimal. So this has to be a wrong measurement. So even if we take everything into account, we get a measurement which is just random. So we have here even this kinesia, so the very red parts show normal kinesia, the blue parts in maximum systole show this kinesia even here. So this would be normal motion of myocardium, or at least as it would be traced, and here we would have a part of this kinesia. So this cannot be normal, so that we cannot take into account. This, of course, we cannot use. We can try to optimize it or just see what happens when we put the delineation more into the myocardium. Here we try to just give it a little bit of a broader view and we try to process it again. So of course you shouldn't do it like that, but if it's in the myocardium, you see the motion again is normal, so now the tracing is better, but still it's just random what we measure here. So that we of course cannot use, so we stop this measurement as well. And now we try to perform an accurate measurement again, and simply by just adjusting it a little bit so we are tracing the endocardial borders, you see that the machine is doing it quite nicely. I do not have to adjust that much. And now let's see what the conclusion is here. So we have now a normal longitudinal strain in this apical four chamber view. Do not include the papillary muscles, that's very important. And be aware, the further you pull the speckles downwards, the measurement of the basal segments will be reduced. Why is that? Always the basal segments are a little bit less contracting compared to the apical segments, but if you just put it more down, you're tracking the mitral valve annulus, which is just firmer tissue compared to the myocardium. So you have to be aware to not measure the mitral valve annulus or the left atrium even in this view. So we also take this measurement so we can continue with our next measurement and apical pre-chamber view to succeed in all the measurements. In case if the machine cannot trace it as properly as you would want to, you just have to adjust a little bit more. Here you can make the ROI a little bit broader and let's see what the machine comes up with. You're always free to not use a specific image. So because here in the anteroseptal regions, you see that the tracing doesn't work that nicely. It's only minus 16. Here it's minus 15. Here the tracing maybe doesn't work properly here. It's also not sure what it's tracing. So this view, for example, I wouldn't take even though the measurement overall seems plausible. Also take a look at the curves here. You see that the segment over here, so the mid segment anteroseptal, is contracting a little bit dyskinetic compared to the rest. So this might also not be an optimal measurement. So just looking at the B-mode image and the measurements you get out of this, you might not want to use this view.